Dating an impatient person can be challenging if you are not patient yourself, but understanding how an impatient operates isn't impossible. You first need to know a bit more about how they think and interact with others. Today we are talking about sex in marriage. We're talking about men or women who is impatient, or who amongst them is more impatient when it comes to sex. A program is Turn Up Still Does. Hello and welcome to another exciting edition of your program Turn Up on Canal The English. It's a program that seeks to empower women and the girl child. And today we still have a wonderful woman to talk to you about an important topic. We are talking about marriage, we are talking about sex, we are talking of how to build marriages, how to put smiles on the faces of couples out there. You know, today in society today we have so many broken homes, families are affected, and we brought in women who have a medical doctor, who have a specialist. She is a counselor as well. She's going to be telling us how to put smiles in your marriage, how to make yourself happy with your husband. We have a lot of package for you tonight. Still this. We have two beautiful ladies to talk about today's topic, which is sex in marriage, where we're focusing on impatience. We talk of anger, we talk of how well can you make a woman feel comfortable during a sexual intercourse, or talk about sexuality as a whole. I have Dr. Fawn Elizabeth. She is a CEO of Tesho Counseling Center. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Maureen. Thank you.
Yeah, just to remind you that she was here last week to talk about this same topic. It's a topic that we extended because you were so interested in it, and you told us, you sent us your worries, and we said let's continue with the topic of today. So I want you to send your SMSs on the number you're seeing on your TV screen. You can send your reactions, you can send your worries, and we'll have answers to your worries. We equally have another person with us in the studio. She is called Ayok Anastasia Blessing. She is into chaplaincy and interpretation. Did I pronounce it well?
Yeah.
Now, what is it all about? You have a lot of things you're doing together.
Yeah, chaplaincy is found in a Mercyship Africa. So Mercyship Africa is in Cameroon.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm one of them. I'm working as a chaplaincy. Chaplaincy is we counsel, we encourage, we pray for them, and also to give smile on people's face mm-hmm. before they go for the operation mm-hmm. and help them to recover.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you look at the cases that come there, how do you do this? What do you tell them? How do you boost them up?
Oh, no, some people came, they are discouraged.
Mm-hmm.
Because can you imagine a child born with that? Maybe legs are just, in fact, a child would have never walked all her life. But through Mercy, when she came, I can remember this lady, this little girl, 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
When this little girl came, it was so amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I saw her and I just look at her, I said, can you imagine? I said, Maureen. I look at this lady, I said, hey baby, don't worry. Everything will be fine for you. Today she can walk. She can walk. There's a young boy who was born, the two legs are up like this for all his life. He has been working with his buttocks, but Mercy she has operated that child, and now the child is walking, and it's normal like both of us.
And now that's the result you have when you see them pulled on, this smile, they're back on their feet. That is what you're expecting to get from these families.
Yeah, and sometime, some of them came, we discover after some result, we discover they have HIV. And HIV, they cannot be operated. So we have to counsel them and give them more courage to go and look for their medicament and help them, but they cannot be operated.
Mm-hmm.
You see, we are in that position to help. Sometimes we have bad news, sometimes we have good news.
Now, we are here to talk about sex in marriage. Unfortunately, we have a counselor with us here in the studio. She is a medical doctor. Dr. Fawn Elizabeth, I'll start with you. I want us to start with anger. Anger. Can anger kill sex?
Of course. course, anger kills sex. Maureen, it's so easy for anger to kill sex, especially in a woman. Especially in a woman because she's an emotional being. For example, a man is in the house with his wife. They are going to go somewhere. Mm-hmm. She's a little tardy in getting ready. And then the man gets angry. He starts insulting her. Mm-hmm. Hey, you are always so lazy. You are always making me to go late. Hey, you this lazy woman. Mm-hmm. She starts getting angry. Mm-hmm. An emotional woman, she's already low emotionally. Mm-hmm. And then when they go out, she says something. He gets angry. Says, shut up your mouth to a woman. Shut up your mouth. That just kills the sex. You go back with her that evening, you try to touch her, she'll be a back of
ice. Cannot, you know, she cannot even respond.
She cannot respond. Mm. Anger towards a woman from the husband kills her desire
now,
for sex.
What would make the man to even if the couple should have problems, does it mean at the time when they should have their nice moments, that anger should still come in?
The truth is that many African men are not conscious because men are different from women. For a man, you can insult him in the living room. You go to the bedroom, you give him what you have to give him, mm-hmm. he'll still take it. You mm-hmm. give a chop, he'll still chop. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. But that's his nature. He's a physical being. Mm-hmm. Insulting him will not mean anything to him. Mm-hmm. But for a woman, you better be very, very careful about her emotions. Mm-hmm. So anger is not good for a woman.
Now, Nastasia, now we have women that can a woman like just like get frustrated when she sees a man like angry or throwing out insults on her? Can it kill that sexual desire in her spontaneously?
Of course, Maureen, just as doctor have just said, you know, a woman is, people usually say that women are like mother. A woman, mm-hmm. when you love a woman, you will have everything you want. Now, when a woman is frustrated, when there is anger in a woman's heart, sometimes she even minimizes you, and she disrespects you. Mm-hmm. And she disrespects you. And when a woman begins to disrespect you, you will have nothing from her. Mm-hmm. Don't expect anything from her. Because woman is like a flower. You have to keep that flower every day, water that flower. If you don't water that flower, you will kill the flower. Mm-hmm. Gradually, you will kill the flower. So frustration and anger can kill the desire of a woman in sexual relationship.
At times, the woman is forced to succumb, doctor, just to please the man. Yeah, then she's not pleasing her own self.
In our culture, mm-hmm. when a man pays bride price to on a woman, that woman is his property. That's what he believes. Mm-hmm. And often he treats her like a piece of property, expecting her to fulfill his desires, his carnal desires, without thinking of her emotional needs. Mm-hmm. That's what happens in most of our relationships. That's what I see at the Teshu Family Center. You have a woman who comes in, she's so angry because the husband does not think of her. He doesn't praise her in public, in front of the children, in front of the in-laws. He does not protect her in front of his family. He talks to her anyhow. Mm-hmm. He doesn't praise her for the work that she does, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, she cleans the house, she cooks the food, he comes and he eats. No thank you. Mm-hmm. In the end, this woman is so tired. She goes to bed. He wants the sex. She gives him. She just sleeps like a log or gives him, you know. There's no heart in what she's doing.
So the woman is a victim here?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Anastasia, the woman is a victim.
Yeah.
And at that point, what can she do?
It's very difficult. It's very difficult because I can just remember a story.
Because you have to sustain your marriage. You have to keep your marriage. Most women say, no, I have children. I have to keep the marriage. I don't want my man to go out. At that point, you're angry, you're annoyed, and the man wants something. You know what he wants. And what do you do?
Marriage is not bondage. First of all, marriage is not a bondage. Just as doctor have just said, men, African men thought that when you pay the bride price, she become a property. But it's not true. Marriage is a matter of love and understanding. Mm-hmm. Okay, I have a story of this young woman who came and met me the other day and she said, I have a problem with my woman, so what? He said, my husband and I, after sex, he will just abandon the bed and went in the parlor doing whatever he wants. He cannot appreciate me. He cannot say anything. Or someday he begins to snore. He fell asleep and begins to snore. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine? And she said, I'm tired of this man. What kind of marriage is this? This is not what I was expecting. Then I told her, have you tried to talk with the man so that you find out what is going on? And she said, yes. But that is the nature of the man. That is the nature of the man. And this lady, I told her, for me, I used to ask people to go and pray. I said, pray. Pray, and with advice, God will help you. But in that case, she's like in bondage. She's like in bondage.
Now, does a woman have a right to say yes? Can she say no?
Of course. The woman have the right to say yes and to say no. Because marriage is not a bondage. Marriage is understanding. It's both people who love themselves together. Because if I love myself as a man, I will never harm myself. So what I will do is that I will look the good of myself. It means the wife is yourself. And you have to care about the wife. So I have the right to say yes, I want, as I have the right to say no. If I don't have the right to say yes or no, it will not become your property. You bought me to the market. So now
doctor wants to react to that.
Yes, I want to react to that. I want to say that women should give men a break. Because men, many of them have been married only for the first time. They don't have any experience in marriage. And you know, when the start of the marriage is passion. At that time, it's so easy for the man to please a woman. And the woman is hot with passion for him. But many of them don't understand that it changes. When the children come, with age and so on, the things change. The man has to work. The African man is too proud. And his ego is big like this. He doesn't want to lower himself to ask his wife, please, my dear, what can I do to please you? He thinks of the old routine, he does things the same way, and the woman is there suffering in bondage. He does not understand that things have changed and that he too has to change. He needs to take time to caress a woman, and that's why, Maureen, we make it simple at Tesho, you know. We say the husband is the team captain, the wife is the coach. They have a very important match to play. It's in three phases, before the match, during the match, after the match. Before the match is a chauffeur. So he has to ask his wife, what can I do? Because if there's no good a chauffeur in your rapper match, men have to get it in your rapper match. And there are so many men who just go ahead and they do it because they think they have a hard on, they can do anything. That is not love making.
Now, we sample the opinion of some couples. We'll be right back.
The best marriage advice I've gotten so far, I think, is the one that says I should work hard to be my wife's best friend, and I'm really working hard towards it.
The greatest advice I've received so far was on my wedding day. The pastor said I should not leave my husband, that anywhere he's relocating to, whether in the forest, outside the country, I must be with him. I should always be there with him.
My first need as a married man is respect. I interpret everything my wife does as love, as care, in that one word, respect.
One is one family time.
I believe a bit of our understanding. I long to be understood.
Secondly, shopping around. What will make me a perfect partner?
I've got Christ in me, 100%, so I'm fun to be with.
I say the truth, and I have a great, wonderful sense of humor.
I love myself, and I'm comfortable with myself. I love myself enough to love somebody else.
I know that I'm ready because I'm very accommodating, you know, and then I'm a good friend, I'm a good listener. So why not? Why don't I get married?
Well, I have a good listening ear.
Aside the fact I am superlatively caring, I think I have a learning spirit. You know, I am always willing to learn.
I've heard so much teachings about marriage, and I'm ready to submit, you know, that submission kind of thing. So that's why I think I'm ready to get married.
One, it has to be very, very supportive.
Someone that is very open. You can share anything, like no hidden thing.
A good listener.
A man who worships God from his heart. And number two, he has to be an encourager and hardworking.
Of course, she must be a good Christian, a practical Christian.
She should better know how to say the truth too.
Someone who I can laugh with, have fun with, not too serious.
He has to be very, very financially buoyant. At least he should be able to, you know, give me one or two when I don't have.
Then she has to be supportive.
The third one, he should be very, very clean.
He should be God-fearing.
And she has to be extremely beautiful.
What else?
Back here in the studio, I'm accompanied by Dr. Fon and Anastasia. They are all women. They are sharing their opinion of sex in marriage. And we just watched that vox pop. Now, can I have your reaction after watching that? Especially when we talk about top qualities. What are the top qualities you can have in your partner?
The truth is that I'm not surprised. They are young people. Mm-hmm. Young people think they discovered marriage and sex, you know, not knowing that their parents went through it and that the first thing in marriage is God. Mm-hmm. The foundation has to be God. Mm-hmm. You build on that foundation. Mm-hmm. And then you have to understand that all those fairy tale things, they are going to come down to earth after some time. Marriage is commitment, working on it, building friendship, building a relationship where you can communicate. It takes work. It's not a fairy tale, Maury. You know, children like that, they need to understand the realities of marriage. How do you treat in-laws? How do you manage money? How do you treat stepchildren? How do you pay the bills? Those things they need to learn.
Now, what do make a couple a perfect couple? What are those things?
There is no perfect couple.
There is no perfect couple
in earth. No.
Why?
That is why we have to love each other and accept ourselves just as we are. Because first, the first marriage in the Bible was Adam and Eve. They were not perfect. But what makes them to be together, even when Adam sinned and Eve sinned, when Adam was chased out of the garden, Eve followed the husband. Understand? If you know the husband, why? Because of the love, not because they were perfect. In this world that we are living today, as doctor was saying, people don't think that everything is honey. At the beginning, I love you chocolate, I love you sweet, I love you honey. When you enter the matter, it's another story.
It becomes different.
Yes.
When you start giving him children, 1, 2, 3, 4.
That the same guy that was buying you Yahoo and chocolate, he will come back with those things, and he will say, this man has changed. Because at the beginning, it's like that.
Yeah, Doug, you want to share the same view?
I mean, I want to say, Maureen, if women don't understand that in marriage is completing each other, many women wait for their husbands to please them, even in bed. They don't understand that they have a role to play. And that's why we say, you are the coach. If this match is not going well, the problem is you. You didn't give the team captain the good instructions. You understand? If there is a chauffeur before, what should he do? And in this marriage, what are you doing to make it great? You don't just sit and wait. My husband has not done this. My husband has... No. That's not marriage.
Now, what is the role of a woman?
A woman, according to the Bible said, the woman have to be a helpmate. And also, the woman have to be submissive. It means a woman, for example, in the Garden of Eden, Adam was there before Eve. Eve came just to help Adam, not to tell Adam what to do. You come to contribute to what your husband have already in mind and to build what he has as a project. But sometimes some women came, when it comes, they just want to, in fact, to impose. Sometimes we find crisis in marriage. She wants to impose. Maybe she wants to bring her own way of living. Because when you're single, you have your own way of living. When you become a married woman, things become different. So to be a woman to help your husband, you have to be submissive and a caring woman. That's why I use the first word. A woman is like a mother. A mother is somebody who cares. Her heart always beats for her children. That's why a wife, because they are women, but to find a wife is different.
Now, talk.
Maureen, you know this thing about submission. Let's talk about it. Do you know that that's the only passage that some men have read in the Bible? My wife does not respect me. Mm-hmm. She's not submissive to me. Mm-hmm. Even in bed, she has to be submissive. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. Let him do what he wants. But they forget mm-hmm. that the same Bible says, love your wife. Mm-hmm. And if you ask men, how do you show your wife that you love her? Mm-hmm. They don't even know. Mm-hmm. You know, it starts with the way you treat her in mm-hmm. the living room, the way you treat her in the society, mm-hmm. the way you talk about her when she's not there, and all those things. So submission, if I submit to you, you have to love me.
Now, I want to talk about between a man and a woman. We're talking about impatience here.
Yeah.
Now.
Okay.
Who is not impatient when it comes to marriage? Who among them is not impatient when it comes to sex or sexuality?
He's a man.
He's a man.
He's a man.
Yes,
he's
a man.
A man.
Why?
Because men, they're impatient.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can find it when you have a problem with their wife, you will see immediately the man will just go at the first woman he will saw. He will just say, mm-hmm. he will just say, let's go.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But the woman, when even if she's divorced with the husband, it takes time for her to recover.
Mm-hmm. No, Maureen, naturally, men are impatient. You understand? Mm-hmm. Let me tell you why. Mm-hmm. Normally, when people get married, mm. the passion is so hot. Everything is
mm-hmm.
fine.
Mm-hmm.
Then things change. Children mm-hmm. come. Mm-hmm. The men who are impatient, mm-hmm. not seeing the changes from their wives, they go out for polygamy.
Mm-hmm.
That was a coping mechanism in our father's days. Today, they go out for deuxième bureau because they don't have the patience. They don't have mm-hmm. the humility
mm-hmm.
to say, this woman has changed. Let me take time to learn about her, to study the new woman now. They are so impatient. She's not responding to me. She's not doing what I want. He goes out. Either polygamy or deuxième bureau. We have it every day. And we know the consequences. Men are more impatient in relationships than women.
Now, I want to ask, why?
Nature.
Mm-hmm.
By the way men are created, mm-hmm. different from women,
mm-hmm.
they are more impatient. And men like to test new things.
Mm-hmm.
They like to taste new things. Mm-hmm. I mean, I always give this example of men, the male species, being like the cock variety.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? One hen, two hen, three hens, four hens, and, you know, they are not patient with any one hen. That's the way men are. So, if you're going to keep a man interested in you, the women, they have to put precautionary measures.
Mm-hmm.
They have to change. This one woman, it's different women
mm-hmm.
to the man in the bedroom.
Now, what are the precautions a woman can take to make a man patient enough or focus on her?
For me, I usually advise ladies
mm-hmm.
to be submissive, lovely.
We have men who are submissive. They will love the man. But the man, I mean, he's still...
He's not even permitted for a woman to love a man. He's not even permitted. Because women are already so good and so kind.
Mm.
So it's not permitted even to a woman to love, because if a woman loves, she will suffer.
Why?
Because even God knows that the Bible said that men love your wife and women be submissive.
Mm-hmm.
Because God knows that man works with hurts.
Mm-hmm.
So he need to love. So if a woman loves, she will suffer.
Mm-hmm.
So it's good for the man to love.
Mm-hmm.
And because if the man loves, everything he needs, the woman will give.
Mm-hmm.
So the man need to love. So me, I don't advise people to love.
Yeah. So you don't advise a woman to love a man, she should rather be submissive.
Blessing, whether she likes it or not, you are going to fall in love. And that is why I tell women to always remember the three C's. C like communication. She has to learn the right communication in her marriage. It's so important that a woman should know how to communicate respect. You know, when a man says, I want a submissive wife, it means that she has to communicate submission.
Mm-hmm.
Non-verbal and verbal mm-hmm. language has to communicate submission.
Mm-hmm.
See, like in comprehension, she has to understand the man.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of man she's married to. What makes him happy?
Mm-hmm.
What makes him feel good in his society? His vision, his passion. All those things are important for a man.
Mm-hmm.
A woman has to comprehend him and see like creativity. Like I say,
mm-hmm.
this one woman, you are going to be several women mm-hmm. to this one man in the bedroom.
Mm-hmm. Which yes. means that, can we say that a man is that selfish type? He thinks just about himself and does not think about the woman if she's happy even in bed?
I don't think all the men are like that. I don't think so. There are some men who are very good and very kind. Yeah, not every man is like that. Because you see, about marriage, Doctor was saying, if you are young, you will go in marriage with emotion. You don't even understand what marriage is all about. But there are some men, they are understanding. They love their wife. They are so caring. Can you imagine when a man goes to work and he's back? The woman goes to work and she's back. Together they will enter the kitchen, both of them. They will be cooking together. That is love. Not because the woman wants to overturn
the... Is it a reality? Do we find such couples?
Of course.
They are rare. They are rare, but because the men are humble enough to learn. You know, they are rare. And because the women, too, have brought the men around, yes, to doing it. It takes a lot of work, Maureen. But if the woman understands that this man is kata-kata by nature, you understand? That in order to get him to do what she wants, she has to first give him what he wants.
Like what, for example?
Good sex, great sex.
I want us to watch this report. We went to the Tertial Counseling Center in Accra, Douala, Cameroon. Let's watch this report. We'll be right back. With a smile on her face, Dr. Fon Elizabeth is on top form to begin her day at the Tertial Counseling Center.
She loves for real. When a woman loves, she loves for real.
The experienced medical doctor, whose footprints has been established in the public health sector in Cameroon, is concerned about the ever-increasing number of broken homes, fallen family standards, and the alarming rate at which marriage is split up these days.
In Bonanjo Court, there are 50 applications for divorce each month. Dokoti Court, about another 50. So statistics show that 50% of young people who get married run into problems. And when you ask people who are married, how is your marriage? They'll tell you, doctor, na tie hat, na management, na roof the cover all thing. And she will say, the men are drinking in the bars, they are afraid to go home, the women are staying in the marriages because of the children.
Telling her story is the best method she is using in restoring broken homes and relationships. A happy family and beautiful marriage life she is portraying through these pictures.
And then it's done, your little winning streak. And summer now to deal. Invincible defeat. You live your life as if it's real. A thousand kisses.
Sometimes the man will slap the woman because the woman is talking too much. Sometimes the woman does not understand that the man is stressed out. Sometimes it's the woman does not respect the man. She talks to him anyhow in public. So he gets mad. When they get home, he slaps her out of anger because men don't know how to talk a lot like women. Sometimes it's children who are heady. When they reach 18, 19, they are heady. The parents don't know what to do. So, you know, they start maybe scolding them. The children become headier, and then it stresses the parents up.
These contrasts with these photos that shows
how couples get stressed up to the point of getting out of the marriage, even if it means sleeping in a bed that surprises the couples with barbed wires, some are ready to do so.
They come in because they have problems. Then we realize that they also have problems with children. So we bring the children in and we also counsel the children, like children's therapy, couples therapy, how do they communicate. We give them guidance through all of that. You know, so we have psychologists who work here. We have doctors who work here. So they go through with the family members to see where they have conflicts, and then we give them skills to resolve those conflicts. It might be money management, we tell them how to resolve. It might be communication, we tell them how to resolve, how to build team spirit. The concept is simple. The husband is the team captain, the wife is the coach, the children are the star players. They form a team. How do they interact in that team? That is what we try to teach them here, to interact, so they can be the winning team.
She tells the different stages of the couple's therapy.
So we build up 12 modules, and that's why we call it TESHO, Team Spirit Holistic, because living in a family should be looked at from a holistic point of view, you know. We cannot just take one thing, sex, resolve sex and think the marriage will be okay. Resolve in-law issues and think the marriage will be okay. Resolve stepchildren issues and think the marriage will be okay. It's holistic. Normally, the women are so emotional. They are the ones who come, you know, they are the ones who first come. Then, when they've had success, they change their behavior in the house. The men are surprised. But where did you go to? So I went to the Tesho Family Center. Okay, let's go there. I want to go there too. Then the men come afterwards. When they come, they fill the questionnaire, they communicate with their wives, then the relationship now becomes much better. Sometimes too, we bring in the children. Children have a problem, especially teenage children, with their parents. We bring them in, they learn how to talk to their parents, how to praise their parents, how the parents too can praise them, and you know, they come out as a winning team.
Situated in the heart of Accra, Douala, Cameroon, TESHO Counseling Center was created in March 2017. 5 months after its existence, the center has registered at least 200 couples of different strata of society and cultural background.
We gather up our hearts and go.
I started thinking about TESHO when I started treating patients who have HIV and tuberculosis. You know, nobody goes out to have HIV. People normally will tell me, doctor, I went out because my marriage was not good. My wife stayed for 2 years without giving me sex. And when I called the wife and talked to her, she would be like, doctor, that man is stupid. He talks to me anyhow. He does not respect me. So I realized that I could talk about faithfulness in marriage until I was red in the face. So long as I didn't resolve their family problems, they will always have problems.
A vision she is sending out to couples through this publication, titled A Great Husband for a Great Wife.
We also have home visits where you go in their natural environment and you talk to them. You first observe. Observe to see how they interact with each other. Sometimes it's the frowns, you know. You enter a house, there's tension in the air, the frowning, they're not talking to each other. Then you start listening to them one by one in their natural environment. Then you start telling them that it's not easy to live in a family. But if you do this, if you do that, if you are patient, if you use this language instead of this one, you'll have better results.
Married and a mother of three, Dr. Fawn Elizabeth has worked in various capacities in the Cameroon public health system. Her last appointment was a literal coordinator for national TB and HIV control. Backed by her husband, Mr. Fontagios, a business tycoon, the happy family viewed the Tesho marriage as a precious gift from God that needs to be shared with other families.
Report. Anastasia, did you know we have a counseling center in Douala? A
not
center
yet.
To counsel families that are suffering from broken homes. And from what Dr. Fon said, we have roughly more than 50 couples every day knocking at the in court who have like dropped their petitions for divorce in courts. The statistics,
every
does
month.
It like every month?
Yeah.
Does it like, it's quite a disturbing statistics. Does it ring anything in your mind? Are you surprised by the statistics? Are you taken by surprise with that?
I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised because, as we were saying before, people don't take the matter of marriage very serious.
Yeah. Yeah.
People enter into marriage with an emotion. Because to get married, you need to be a man. You need to be a woman. You need to be matured. Know what you are doing. If you just enter into marriage because the man is handsome, the handsomeness may not be there in 2 years' time. Maybe you enter to the marriage because the woman is beautiful. What happened before or what happened after may cause you not to love her again because the love was there, it was for beauty. So the best reason to get married is to love. And marriage is understanding.
But you say a woman should not love.
No, I'm not talking of a woman.
Oh, okay. The man should love.
I'm going to tell you why I say a woman should not love. I'll tell you.
Okay.
I'm talking, the man needs to love the wife. When you love the wife and you obey the principles, the Bible principles, you will make it. You will make it. Because the Bible principles have the God-fearing. You will make it. But today people just rush getting married. Some get married in bar. In the morning, they divorce. You go and took. You, in fact, you enter some. You enter to a place. You just met a lady and say, "I love you. Let's go and get married now." You go and get married. 3 months later,
kaput.
It become earthquake.
That's it.
And they say, "What is going on?" No, because they have not understood what marriage is all about.
That's true. What we have a prenuptial preparation at the Tesho Family Center to teach young people about the realities of marriage. Maureen, it's very important. You cannot plan a big wedding and not teach the young people how to live in a marriage.
Now, I want to ask a question. I don't know. Who enjoys marriage more? Is it a man or the woman?
Normally, both of them was called to enjoy because it's a business of two people. It's a matter of two people. So both of them are called to enjoy. But now, there's something also in marriage that when you look at your own personal interests, you will enjoy the marriage alone. And your partner will not enjoy the marriage.
And who is looking at this personal interest? Who is more focused on, I mean, we're talking of self-interest here.
Yeah.
Who is that? Is it a man or the woman?
Sometimes in some cases you find the man, in some cases you find the woman.
You find the woman.
Yes. Sometimes in some cases you find the woman, sometimes in some cases you find the man. But I believe something is that if you love your wife, I used to say that, if you love your wife, she will give you all what you want. And if a woman is understandable, if she can understand the man, because sometimes imagine, the man may be back in the evening, he needs an ear to talk, to listen to him. Maybe the day was bad. But when he's back, you begin to say, "Hey, do you know what happened today? Hey, do you not have this? This is what happened. This is what happened." Just like we saw there with the megaphone.
Yeah.
She was shouting at the husband's ear. You see, for example, the man will get tired. He gets tired. There are some characters that also women will have to try to learn and comport. Truly. Sometimes we don't always say men, there are some good men outside.
There are many good men.
Yes, women have changed them. They were very good at the beginning with the woman. And sometimes she said, I have a friend of mine, she said, "Moi, si je me marie, mon mari, moi, c'est dépatage de travaux à la maison." Non, on se dépatage de travaux. Est-ce que c'est moi qui dois travailler? You see, with that mentality, she will not go far. I told her that he will not go far. He will not make it.
An African man, they cannot go far.
He can. You cannot go far. An African man, you come and say that we should wash plate together.
Ah, yeah.
My friend, in fact, you will not even see him.
But you have men who do that.
No, the thing is that
their wives
are home. The truth is that let him not do it as an obligation.
That's the problem.
He has to do it as an act of love. In marriage, we teach that they complete each other. You complete each other. It's not a matter of me being more than you. I am different from you. You understand? So I do my own and you do your own. We complete each other. We are so happy to be together. We can wash clothes together. It's our time together. You understand? We can take care of the baby together. It's our baby. Not that it's your job. You must do it. The man will slap you. Who says, me? I paid bride price for you. You know,
now, so I want to ask some little tips. Now, we're getting running out of time. Now, what are some of the tips that women can use? Can you give us some, like, let me say in French, you'll say astuce. Can you give us some little tips on how to build your marriage or keep your marriage and make your husband focus on you?
Yeah. You can do things like surprise. Sometimes your husband is not around. Just go and buy something he like and put it on the bed. When he enter the room, he find a very beautiful gift on the bed. He'll be very happy. And sometimes you can just surprise a man. Maybe he's at a job site. You just call him during the day. Hey, baby, how are you? How are you doing? How is the job? Oh, I miss you. You see, those kind of things, there are many things like that to keep your man. He'll be thinking of you, my dear.
Maureen, for me, what I do is that I read the word of God with him and I pray for him with him. I thank God for him. So I tell God, thank you for this wonderful, faithful husband that you've given me. I tell God, this man, I cover him with the blood of Jesus. He will not be he will not be unfaithful. And then, like she says, I will call him, I will thank him, I will ask him what I need to do as a wife to please him, and I listen when he talks, and I try to do what he wants me to do. And of course, as I say, you are different women to him in the bedroom.
Now, I want to thank you ladies for honoring the invitation.
Thank you.
Certainly we'll have another time to discuss more interesting topics about women, because we are here to empower women. We are here to make our women to build them up economically, socially, and otherwise. We've come to the end of this edition of the program, Turn Up on Canal V English. Thanks for watching. Together, rendezvous same time next week. Goodbye.